Good morning, Cardinal Ambrosic. Today is Tuesday, April the 27th, 2021. And this morning we have a very special prayer intention and one that is very close to home. We pray this morning for the repose of the soul of Emily Victoria Vegas, a 13-year-old teenager who died of the COVID-19 virus and attended St. John Henry Newman Catholic Elementary School in our Dufferin Peel Catholic District School Board. It is with great sadness this morning that we have learned of the recent death of Emily Victoria Vegas. We pray this morning for her parents, all her relatives and friends, and especially for all of the staff and students at St. John Henry Newman Catholic Elementary School in Brampton East for their immense grief and great loss. Faced with an agonizing situation, let us lift our prayers and thoughts to our God this morning, as we pray for all who continue to be affected by the pandemic, most especially all essential workers, and all of the many doctors and nurses who continue to give relentlessly to the ongoing care of all patients. And so with that, please join me this morning as we pray in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us ask the God of all consolation to open our hearts to his words, so that listening to them, we may comfort one another, find light in time of darkness, and faith in time of doubt. Let us listen to these words from Scripture, and these are taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 1 to 3. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may also be." With God, there is mercy and fullness of redemption. So let us now together pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Let us pray. Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, surround the family of Emily with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon Emily, and may Emily rest in peace. Amen. And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, good morning, Cardinal Ambrosic, and certainly not an easy morning today to bring to you that news of the passing of Emily, but really to show, or to, I guess, to make real the severity of our situation and of the COVID virus, of the variants that are currently here with us. And so please take care of yourself, stay at home, only go out when you need to, you know, make sure that you socially distance, and let us ensure that we all get back to school safe and healthy come September. Your morning announcements, Cardinal Ambrosic. Another reminder to or a reminder to all grade 9 students who have not been who have not received an email regarding their core team selection for the 2021-22 school year, a Google Form application will be made available immediately following morning announcements. Therefore, if you are a grade 9 student and have not received an email invite from me confirming your selection to the core team, this form is for you. Please fill it out and submit it to me no later than Friday, April the 30th. So you have until the end of the week. And if you have any questions in the meantime, please do not hesitate to contact me. Attention all students, as you know, our core team has recently proposed an initiative titled the Call Out Box. This is an opportunity for our students to let us know what it is that you need to become more successful, responsible, and proactive, ensuring that all your school needs are met and that you become part of the solution. Looking for additional ways to connect with your peers? How about sharing an issue to address, or how about sharing an issue to address with others? Do you have a gift you wish to share but do not know how? Are you interested in becoming a leader in our school and sharing your talents with one of our CASEL groups? Are you interested? Stay tuned for more information to follow in the coming days. Soron CA. Relay for Life at CA, yes, will be taking place next Tuesday, a week from today, during Catholic Education Week, on May the 4th from 6 to 8 p.m. You can follow us on Instagram at CA_RelayForLife for any daily posts and more information. In the meantime, we have included a 30-second introduction promo video, which has been provided to us by the University of Toronto Scarborough campus. And you can get a glimpse of what the relay is. And also, we are preparing our own promo here at Cardinal Ambrosic to bring to you as we draw closer to our event. A reminder that tomorrow we will be praying the Holy Rosary. Again, that's every Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. at Ambrosic Chaplaincy, and we hope to see you there. And tomorrow night on our Spilling Tea segment, we have our very own Miss Brown, who will be joining us live at Instagram at Ambrosic Chaplaincy beginning at 8 p.m. Trust me, you don't want to miss this. There's some wonderful, wonderful stories there and a real, real unique vocation story. And a reminder that it is the Virtue of the Month nomination period. Virtue of the Month for April is love. You shall love the Lord God with all your heart and mind and soul and strength. And the second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. And so a Google nomination form has also been included for you following morning announcements. And yesterday we had, wow, we had about 50 nominations submitted. Remember, my goal was 100 a few months ago, even last month. Let's see if we can reach our 100 this month. But you have until the end of the week to submit your nominations. And again, of one of your peers that you believe has been living out the virtue of love. And again, next week is Catholic Education Week, as you know, and the theme for Catholic Education Week is Nurturing Hope. And so yesterday I highlighted for you our Relay for Life Cancer event, and today I want to highlight for you our Spilling Tea event, which will be on Wednesday, May the 5th at 6 to 8 p.m., and it'll be with Dr. Mark McGowan. Now, I'm sure that many teachers will know who Mark McGowan is. He's a historian, he's a professor. Dr. Mark McGowan is also the principal currently at the University of St. Michael's College at U of T. He was actually the president, former president, for 9 years at the university. He kind of came out of retirement to help out with the principal position while they find a new one. And as well, he is informed and as educated, really the guru of publicly funded Catholic education in Ontario. He really, really is the go-to guy when we talk about Catholic education and public funding for Catholic education in Ontario. He is a wonderful, wonderful man, lives out in Whitby, has a beautiful family, 4 children, and we look forward to having him with us. Again, that's on Wednesday, May the 5th. Don't miss it. This is as good as it gets when it comes to Catholic education, and we have him with us on Spilling Tea at 8 p.m. And also, I made a request yesterday, and I'll continue to make that request today, and I'll send out an email this morning. Sorry, yesterday kind of got away from me, and I wasn't able to get the email out to staff, but I am encouraging and inviting staff members to share their vocation story during Catholic Education Week. The hope is to have you live with us on Cardinal's Cry, because we're having a special edition on the Thursday where we will be celebrating Catholic education. But I would really love to hear from you, the teachers, about your vocation story. Why you chose to be a Catholic teacher? Because you didn't have to, right? You could have simply gone and worked at a public school, but you chose a Catholic school. And we would love to hear your story. And so I invite staff to really consider to share your story, whether it's in written form, whether it's live with us, or even a recording. And that would be a great, great example and witness to all of our students. So I invite you to be part of that. And that's it for your morning announcements, Cardinal Ambrosic. It looks like we're getting some rain in the next few days, so I'm not sure if you have a chance today maybe to get out. I'm not sure how sunny it'll be. It's a little cloudy already, but know that you're in my daily prayers as always, and I hope that you have a wonderful, wonderful day. God bless you, Cardinal Ambrosic.